Hello, and thank you for joining us today. My name is Adam Hostetter. I'm with SAF North America. I am the Test and Measurement Sales Manager, and today we are going to go over the operation of SAF's Spectrum Manager software that you can use for analysis of the work that you do with our Spectrum Compact product. So the first thing that we're going to do, if you're not familiar with it, Spectrum Compact is an ultra compact spectrum analyzer. We have products that are available from 300 megahertz on up to 87 gigahertz. If you'd like to learn more, please visit our website at saftechnica.com. So to get Spectrum Manager software, you're going to want to go to our website and click support. Then you will go to downloads and you will select the Spectrum Compact family. And here you will look for the Spectrum Manager PC software. Now, in this view, I'm only seeing where I can download the software itself. If you log in and create an account, that's where you will be able to get additional information on Spectrum Compact family, as well as sample traces to play with. Once you have Spectrum Manager downloaded on your PC, you'll want to go to the icon here. And one thing, if you're using Windows 10, you'll want to go to Properties. You will want to select Compatibility, and you will want to disable Full Screen Optimization. This is a function of the scaling features in Windows 10. So with that done, we will now open up the Spectrum Manager software. So here's where it will show your local cache. When you have a Spectrum Compact hooked up to your computer, you're going to do that via USB, and it's going to show in your directory as a mass storage device. So I don't have one hooked up right now, but if I did, I could redetect if I had a different unit than this one, or I could start real time. So that's where you can actually run the Spectrum Analyzer from a PC as a remote control versus using it as a standalone device. But for the sake of today, I'm going to go ahead and import some files that I have saved on my computer. So what the Spectrum Compact does is save files in two proprietary formats. The first format is a single sweep mode called Spectrum SCC. The second is recordings. So if you're doing a site survey or you're trying to understand what's happening over time within a certain environment, that's where you'd want to use the record mode on the device and then download the full recorded section. So we'll go ahead and click the recorded ones. And what I'm going to do is open up some signals that we just pulled here in the office, looking at various Wi-Fi and cellular signals. So with those open, we now have the interface of the software itself. Up here in the left-hand corner, you can see this is file one of 202. And of course, I will show a little bit later how to do an overlay feature where you can view all 202 sweeps at the same time. Now, just to get you familiar with the panel here, so our first thing here is the frequency controls. There's a couple of different ways that you can set this up. You can set up your center frequency manually. So you could go here and say you want to look at 2400 as your center frequency, and that's going to automatically change my span. I could also set separate start-stop frequencies, or you can use your mouse to scroll through, and what I'm doing here is shrinking. In the case of this device, the minimum span is 100 megahertz, or I can go to the full span that I was able to find. So that is, now we're scrolling through there. So now for span, I'm going to go ahead and make that the full span of what that sweep was. So that's the way that you can zoom in if you have a particular frequency of interest or you have an event that's of particular interest. The other piece here in the software is our marker function. So you can put up to 10 markers in here. So what I'll do for this one is go ahead and set my A marker at the maximum displayed value. For B, I will go ahead and do my minimum displayed value. And then of course, here, if I want to, I can do a delta measurement. So there you can see B was 88 megahertz apart and 62 dB below at a negative 111 dBm. Now, if I want to add different markers besides these max and min, I can go ahead and hit C and I'll hit frequency here. Now, I could enter this here specifically if I just, if I know what I'm looking for, or you can just go into here and click on it and put that marker exactly where you want it in time. So that's a quick overview of the markers. Now we'll go ahead and go down to the tools. So we do have a power meter function in the Spectrum Compact. We also have a power meter function here in the software. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn my power and band on. Now it defaults to the center and it's gonna give me a 10 megahertz wide channel. So here you can see the cumulative power here was negative 76 dBm in this channel itself. Now, if I want to, I can go ahead and either set it up as, excuse me, I can go in here and set up my power to be at a specific frequency point. So let's say I wanted to look at A, and I see that that starts at 2114. We'll go ahead and go in there. There you can see where that was on that. Now you do have the function here to add, load a mask. So you can create your own specific spectrum mask, or you can load a mask from an additional file if you want to do some comparative measurements. I won't get into the details of this, but you do have the availability there. Now, one other piece here that I did not show yet is overlay. So with overlay, this is going to take now, I'm going to go ahead and turn off my power and band. So with overlay, what I'm doing now is taking all 200 sweeps that I made and giving them kind of a graphical representation over time. So your blue sweeps here are your single events, and then on down here to your red, which is down in the noise of the analyzer, what was going on within the different bands here. So there's your overlay feature. Now, once you're done doing the work that you want to do with these, you have a few different options for export. You can save this as a JPEG image. So if you have your own reporting tools, or you're trying to, you know, share some information with someone, you can save the image. You can save the actual file. In addition to saving the actual file, you can export the raw data in a CSV format. And what that's going to give you is a timestamp, the measured frequency point, as well as the power at every measured frequency point. Cancel that. So, and then the other piece is you can actually create your own reports within the Spectrum Manager software. So if you don't have your own reporting tool, you can use the SAF tool to achieve that. So that's kind of the export options there. Now we'll go to import. So this is where you can open additional sweeps, additional files. The other nice function here is you can actually add GPS data. So if you have GPX files that you want to upload, what you can do then in the Spectrum Manager report, once you've uploaded your GPS data, it will give you an overlay of what was happening in the RF spectrum over a certain topography. So handy thing for doing outdoor work. The last piece we'll go to here is, this is where you can, if I had a Spectrum Compact hooked up here, this is where I would be able to enable or disable the real-time mode and, you know, drive it remotely. The other thing is you can update your firmware from here. So because I don't have one connected, I'm not going to get that. So we'll go ahead and let that go. So that's a quick overview of Spectrum Manager software for the SAF Spectrum Compact. If you have any questions, please do visit us at saftechnica.com and click the Contact Us button. And thank you very much for your attention today.